Magandang gabi sa inyo lahat.
Magandang
guwapo gabi sa inyo lahat. And it's a again, may request about the scandal.
The focus of our heart and minds to Him.
But because of some circumstances and events in our life that we are we are vulnerable to any disturbance in our life, we are delivered. Tayo, masalamat dahil ang ating Diyos ay talagang nagligtas sa atin. If you want to see the Hebrews 7:25, I will read it in Tagalog. Dahil dito naman siya ay nakakapagligtas na lubos sa mga silapit sa Diyos. Kung kita niya ay palibasa ay laging namubuhay siya upang mamagitan sa kanila. Siya po ay nagliligtas ng lubos. Wala pong kulang, wala labis, kundi siya po ay Diyos na dapat nangangamit sa atin. And also true that we have a very powerful and sinister enemy whose name is Satan. Thanks God, He is mighty, but our God is almighty.
Amen.
And first, 2 Corinthians 2:11 said, lest Satan should get advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. Although we know very well our enemy, although we know his techniques, strategies, methods, but still, sometimes and most of the time, we are trapped in his method. Sabi nga sa 2 Thessalonians 2:9, siya na ang kanyang pagpapalito ay ayon sa paggawa ni Satanas na sa may buong kapangyarihan at mga tanda at mga kahanahanan kasi tumalingan. He is powerful, but not the most powerful. Only God can do everything. So all of us are a victim of this method. That's why Peter mentioned a verse that be sober. Anong Tagalog sober? Papagmatsyag. You know, in a war, we need to know the capacity of our enemies. Yeah? We need to know the ammunition, no? Kung anong ginagamit. No? We need to know the quantity. That's why the Apostle Peter said, "Be sober, magpapagtiyag tayo." Because tayo nga ay nasa warpath ng pagbaka sa ating kalaban. Now, 1 Peter 5:7 has our adversary, enemy, conflict, opposition. And stumbling block in our Christian belief, Christian life. Some of us are victim of this. Some of us are already there. The devil is a real person. In Acts 5:3, many people, marami mga tao na ito'y kanilang minamalik ang kagayahan, kalaban. Ang ibang tao naman ay akala na si Satanas ay isang monster with two horns. And like when we, tayo mga bata pa, akala natin lahat ng may sumay ay Satanas. The devil is a powerful person. Pero tell us that he is a light, a ruling light, walking about, seeking whom he may devour. He always there. Once, pag tayo ilalim, lumalapit sa Panginoon, ilalim man siya, nagiging agresibo para sa atin. Because we are already the child of God. The devil is an active person. He walked around us and his scheme and maneuvers, strategies, and diabolical is it active in rights of men and women? Let's open our Bibles one again of Timothy, 1 Timothy 5:15. For some are already turned aside after Satan. That's why this person is too powerful, but not most powerful. He is a subtle, an unrecognized. Siya po ay gumagawa ng ayon sa kanyang style, strategies, methods, pamamaraan. At karamihan sa akin ay nahuhulog dito. This message is too light for us, but very thankful. Maybe one of your siblings, Satan is used to stumble you. Not here, somewhere. Because what you're listening right now is Satan is making some strategy now, strategy some method and strategies. But be careful, no? That sometimes Satan reveals himself as an angel of light. St. Corinthians 11:14, and no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. So be careful to those good in speaking, no? Good in looks good, pogi. Be careful of that. Looks beautiful. Baka matrap po kayo. This is only a reminder for all of us. This is only an introduction for this message. And we praise God because God promises to us in Romans 8:35. Romans 8:35, can you stand? Can you open that one? Romans 8:35-39. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress? Persecution, for famine, for nakedness, for peril, for sword. 36. And it's written, for they say we are killed with the day long, we are accounted as sheep for slaughter. 37. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. 38. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come. 39. Nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God with His Christ Jesus, our God. Yeah. God be the glory. Maraming Panginoon sa pagkat hindi tayo kaya iwalay sa pag-ibig ng Diyos. Amen. At sa John 10, 36-30, I will read it to you again. 10:26-30 said, but ye hear it not, because ye are not of my sheep. As I said unto you, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. And I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall anyone pluck them out of my Father's hands. And my Father which give them me is greater than all, and no one is able to pluck them out in my Father's hands. I and the Father are one. Pwede rin Panginoon that mayroon tayo Diyos na hindi kailangan tayo bibitawan. In times of trouble, in times of temptation, in times of any method of this Satan, God is still with us. Now we come to our message for tonight, the devil's method for the individual believers. We focus on verse 8. The whole strategy of Satan is related to the individual believers, maybe sum up in three words. This is very common. Ang mensahe ng gabi. The first word is disturbance. Disturbance meaning the interruption of the settled and peaceful condition. Some of us, galit tayo pag may naistorbo. Especially while we are sleeping. While we are in a table, eating. And especially when we are in love. Our mind, our heart focus on the matter only. So disturbance is using the devil. The devil using this word to distract us, our focus to the Lord Jesus Christ. When I'm studying this afternoon, this message, suddenly I receive a call. And my service told me to go to the ship office. Something problems there. So, yes, I put up the phone. But my mind is start thinking what is to be done, that problem. So, it's not disturbed po yung aking pag-iisip, yung aking pag-iskan. And then, for a while, I lay down my bed and stay calm. So, alam ko, if I started that work, we need to finish because it's a shake office. It's our boss, our big boss. So, suddenly, give me a wisdom. God gave me a wisdom to go early than my usual working hour, working time. So I went there, 2:30. Then when I prepared everything that's in the place, I met that office boy. Then I told him, what's the problem? Oh, you all know? I know, the big work. So I calculated the time. Maybe I finish this program and then the store will open at 4 o'clock. So I will be still 4:30. Then everything until the church. And then he told me, this is easy work, only two black is peace. So my energy is drained because of that. And the first time I saw that guy, that very helpful to me. Just holding my lanterns. And he said, careful. And I can't get because that's only one of these tricks of our enemy. So God's purpose is that every one of His children should experience perfect peace. Not R.I.P. Remember what God said. Perfect peace. In the book of Isaiah, 26 verses that thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, he trusted in thee, whose mind stayed on the Lord Jesus Christ. Plenty of people looking for peace. Even this peace. But they can't find because only Jesus Christ has that peace. If your loved ones back to the Philippines, still peace. But God wants us to be living in a peaceful way. We need to trust God. We need to focus our mind on Him. Peace of heart and mind. Philippians 4:7 said, Paul said, and the peace of God which passeth all understanding shall keep your hearts and minds through Jesus Christ. Through Christ Jesus. Remember the word, keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. So, ang gusto ng Diyos tayo magkaroon ng kapayapaan. Nais ng Diyos na tayo maging masaya bilang mananampalataya. Gusto ng Diyos na tayo maging ma-enjoy natin ang ating kaligtasan. But our enemy always try to pull us down. To pull us down. David said in Psalm 48, I will both lay me down in peace and sleep, for the Lord only maketh me dwell in safety. I took this verse from my brother Tuzel, also on Facebook. I take that verse always posting verses on the Facebook. When such peace is the experience of his children, their lives are characterized by poise and power. But Satan loves us to upset our peace, to disturb us, to disturb our poise, and to rob us of power. His whole objective is to get us down. That's the main objective of our enemy, to get us down. Last month, we experienced some disturbances in our church. But I thank God, I praise God that our church, and people, they need. And I'm appealing to our deacons, our leaders, that's state. Pray for your class. While our pastor is in the Philippines, pray for our BBC, our brethren, sisters and brethren, that the Satan is very active in this moment and time. So, we should, as a believer, we should prepare our mind. We should face the enemy fair and squarely. We need to face it. We don't need to run and hide somewhere. Isolate ourselves to hide. But God give us a power to conquer that battle. We are not ignorant of his devices. But still, tayo, baka alam natin kanyang pamamaraan, but still, tayo nahuhulog sa kanyang mga strategies, sa kanyang pamamaraan. There are many circumstances, events, instances that this enemy tayo po ay naisulo. But thanks God, is there to help us, and He will never leave us, to forsake us at any time that trouble comes in our way. In James 4:7 says, submit yourselves, therefore, to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. That's only a solution. James said, submit yourselves, therefore, to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Number two, second word, disobedience. In our life, since we accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as our personal Savior, how many times that we disobeyed God? Plenty. Even me, I cannot count. Thousands. Thousands. But still, my relationship to my God, I hindi po siya nakukutol. I'm his son, and he is my father. The salvation that gave it to me, still in me. The devil is the great tempter. Started in the Garden of Eden. In Genesis chapter 3, verse 1 to 6, I will read to you. And this very familiar chapter. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made, and said unto the woman, Ye have God said, Ye shall not eat in every tree of the garden. And the woman said to the serpent, We may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God hath said, Ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch, or lest ye die. And the serpent said unto the woman, Ye shall not surely die. For God doth know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. And when the woman saw the tree was good for food, and that was pleasant to the eyes, and the tree to be desired to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof, and gave it, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did it. He tempted, and he disobeyed destruction of God. Evil, destruction is to evil, but Eve still disobeyed destruction of God. The plate of this, every message on this pulpit, our pastors, our deacons, our workers, there's a plenty of instruction that we need to do, but still we love to disobey. It seems we are enjoying those things. Sabi nga may narin na ako sabi niya, sa dami-dami ng preaching ng ating pastor still. Sa dami-dami ng memory verses natin memorize, but still, we disobey God. Still disobey God. This is one of the weapons of our enemy. Little by little, hindi nyo mamalayan, you are eaten by this weapon of our enemy. Be alert. Be calm and alert. If only he can make us disobey the Lord and keep us half-hearted and undecided with regards to the will of God and the word of God. Yes. In going to Bible study, in going to our fellowship, and going to our service, we see some of us are undecided to join. Including me. Sometimes I make some reasons. So I can para di ako pumunta. Oh, I have call. No, I have a emergency call. Because para bang tinatamad ka? Parang tinatamad ka magsalita. Tinatamad ka mag-isip. But that's a trick of our enemy. Kaya nga ang Bible study natin, nagsimula tayo ng mag-inisi yata. Kayo, lima na lang yata. Sana, sa Lea, ibas niya, talaga naman, ano. Kung nawala sa pastor, 2 by 2, 1, at 5 na lang. There's a lot of reason. But thanks God. God, our God, is a merciful God. Siguro kung di tayo pumunta sa Bible study at tayo pinilayan, siguro pumunta tayo lahat, ano? Ay, pumunta, ha? Pinilayan ka. Ay, pumunta. Diba? Diba? Little reason to disobey God. But this is one of the better to walk in him. To disobey him. While disobeying God, this enemy, Satan, is laughing us. Ha, ha, ha. Hey, like on Facebook, no? Join them, okay, it's nice. Punta ka ng Haya, punta ka ng Golma. But thanks guys for our drivers, no? That always available. But last Bible study, nalungkot kami kasi ang laki ng van, tatuloy yung sakay. Kami yung sanag. So, please, be careful. Be sober. No? So, makanahuli na tayo sa trap ni Satanas. And we worship him because of that. And Joshua in the 4:15 said, it's a very familiar, very I will read it to you. And now therefore fear the Lord, and serve him in sincerity and truth, and put away the gods which your fathers served on the other side of God. And Egypt, and serve ye the Lord. And 15, and if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom ye will serve, whether the gods which your fathers served and that fell on the other side of God. The gods, the Amorites, and whose land he built. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Amen. Amen for that. You will choose from this time. Are you choosing evil? Are you choosing God? And in 2 Corinthians 6:4 said, "Bear ye not an equally yoke." Sometimes this word are commonly disobeyed. Even our friend, most madalas tayong kasama ng ating mga kaibigan, unbeliever, because we enjoy it also. To enjoy with them. But dapat natin na-enjoy ang fellowship na believer. You know why? That's a reflection of heaven.
Amen.
Reflection of heaven. While we are singing choirs, practicing choirs, going to Bible studies, and everything, fellowshipping with each other, it's a reflection of heaven.
Amen.
So focus our minds to our Lord Jesus Christ, not on the worldly things. Any situation now, right now, until now, no? Pray to God that you can obey Him in every circumstances in your life. In the circumstances, even you are in a difficult situation, even you are in sickness, even you are in problem, but pray to God that you can obey all the instructions from His Word. That's our duty, to obey Him. In corrupted state of holy life, we should have a self-controlled spirit. We know how to control ourselves. We need to control our feelings. We need to control our everything in us. Sometimes we're affected by our friends. That's only strategy distant regions. All of us are victims of this world. We always disobey God's instruction to us. Number three, third, and the last, defeat. As a Christian, we are no longer belong to the devil. We belong to the Lord by redemption, right? 1 Corinthians 6:20 said, "For ye are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's." Ephesians 1:7 said, "In whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of his grace." And Peter 1:18-19 said, "For as much as ye know that ye were not redeemed with the corruptible things as silver and gold from your vain conversation received by tradition from your fathers. But we, the blood of Christ, as for lamb without blemish and without spot." Defeat is the word that is hard to accept. But it happened to us. But it happened to us. Even though God always reminding us that any time, anywhere, any place, we can call him, but we neglect to call him because of our disobedience. That's why most of us, most of the believers, some of the believers are defeated. Defeated to show their faith to the world, to the believers. Instead of sharing the word of God for them, we play for them. Instead of inviting them, they invite us. Instead of help them, we help us. Our adversary still seeking for our downfall. Hindi po siya namahinga. Tandaan natin. Hindi po siya natutulog. Kung ang Panginoon ay hindi natutulog, kung nag-umiglip, kung pag tayo bantayan, at the same, this person. Every action na natin gawin ay natutulog siya. I remember when I was a new believer, as I mentioned every time, that we encountered this evil. Mari yung dinanwala, but this is, I have experienced this one. It's too powerful. It's a powerful person. But thanks God and my Lord, is more powerful than me. The purpose of this evil to us is to rub the things that we have. What those things? We are going to open the Deuteronomy verse 11, chapter 11, verse 18 to 22. Hand that they may be as frontlets between your eyes. And he shall teach them your children, speaking of them, if thou sittest in thy house, and when thou walkest with the way, when thou liest down, and when thou risest up, and thou shalt write upon the door post of thy house, and upon thy gates, that your days may be multiplied, and the days of your children in the land. The Lord swear unto your fathers to give them as the days of heaven upon the earth. That what I told you for that our fellowship, our activities inside the church is the reflection of heaven. If we are defeated with the scheme of this enemy, this event, you miss that event in your life. Once it happened, it will not come back again. So kung na-miss nyo po yung fellowship natin last Friday, it will not happen again. It's different. So the enemy, kung kayo po ay absent on last Friday, ang napasay nyo ay ang ating dalawa. The enemy, Satan. You love to stay in your house, in your home. Do you think, dito na ako mag-pray? No? Dito na ako magbabasa? No? But, no? Ang yung bigyan ng pagpupuri ay yung kalangan. Because the time that we need to assemble in Christiana is the ito po ay kalooban ng ating Panginoon. So, as a first method of our enemy is disturbance, disobedience, and defeat. These are the ways in which Satan gets to work. What we must do as a Christian is prevent being overcome with a great adversity. Number one, keep calm. Keep calm. Huwag tayo magpanik. Pag tayo nagpapanik, ay siya po ay nakagalat. Kaya nga sabi ng Panginoon, gusto ng Diyos na tayo ibalik. Magkaroon lang kapayapaan. No? Number two, be alert. Be on guard. Be alert. Number three resists the devil. And verse 9. Whom resist steadfast in faith, knowing in the same affection that accomplished in the your brethren that came in the world. To resist, we must give no place to him. Ephesians 4:27. 4:27 said, never give place to the devil. Don't give place in your heart, in your mind. Don't entertain him. We must stand against him. 6:11. Put on the whole armor of God, that he be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. We must stand against him. This enemy that we cannot love. The Bible says, love your enemy, but this enemy, you never will love this. You need to hate him. Is that clear? Don't love him, huh? We need to believe. Satan is very wise. Attacking unrecognized. Ina-attack tayo na hindi natin nalaman. Even those pastors, the people, children of God, still don't in the trap ng kalaban. And we must remember that above all, the God of grace enables us to overcome the great enemy. As a conclusion, let's read in verse 10. And 2 Corinthians 3:19. He said in verse 10, 1 Peter But the God of all grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by grace Jesus, called by Christ Jesus, after that you have suffered a while, make your faith established and then consider it. Very nice verse. But the God of all grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that we have suffered a while, make your perfect, establish, strengthen, and settle you. And put St. Corinthians 9 and 10, this last verse. Well. And he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Most gladly therefore will I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Therefore I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in necessities, in persecution, in distresses, for Christ's sake, for when I am weak, then I am strong. That's why this enemy is no match for us, actually. And that's the truth. The bottom line is, we can defeat him, because he is already defeated in Christ. So this evening, that we need to think. Tayo ba ay ginugulo? Tayo ba ay nire-disobeyed? Or tayo ba ay defeated? The question, this question, or this question, the only answer, can answer by you. If you believe that our God is most powerful than this enemy, then you can say, the way you win this method and strategy of our enemies.